fish at a restaurant is risky. Did you know there's a particular day of the week to steer clear? Or that chef specials can be sketchy? Keep watching so you don't end up green around the gills. It may seem that one day is as good as any other to order fish, but the reality is, the day of the week really does matter. In fact, one of the greatest celebrity chefs of his time, the late Anthony Bourdain, wrote in his book Kitchen Confidential that he never ate fish on Mondays. His reasoning was all about restaurant delivery schedules. Restaurants often only place one seafood order for the weekend, meaning that Monday's fish order could have been sitting in the restaurant's fridge since Friday. Bourdain wasn't the only chef to feel this way. Devin Cameron, chef and owner of food website Braised and Deglazed, told Mashed, "Fish orders almost never come in on Sundays or Mondays, so ordering on Monday means you're probably eating the old fish." That said, this isn't a hard and fast rule for all restaurants. Some restaurants actually get their fish delivered every day. But if you're not sure, it's best to err on the side of caution. Cameron's advice is simple. If you don't trust the restaurant, then don't order fish on a Sunday or Monday. The manager's special at a restaurant seems like it should be the best the chef has to offer. But while that can be true, it's also sometimes one of the diciest things you could order. Special can be a tricky word in a restaurant. It can mean it's the best the restaurant has to offer or exactly the opposite. Maybe it's fridge cleanout day, or maybe the chef is trying to quickly move a surplus of a particular ingredient out of their kitchen. That could easily include old or questionable fish.
"If we don't cook it tonight, Jackie, it'll go all bad, and then it'll get infested with weevils."
If you don't trust the restaurant or chef, or you aren't sure what makes the fish special so special, consider skipping it. According to Cameron, "In a good restaurant, the fish special is a fresh catch of a limited amount of fish that will likely sell out quickly. In a bad restaurant, the fish special is a way to use up fish that's about to go bad." While there are always exceptions, it's typically not advisable to mix cheese and fish. Generally, the delicate flavor of seafood can be drowned out by the heavy, rich texture of cheese. If you've ordered a fresh piece of ahi tuna or a glorious piece of king salmon, you probably want the flavors of the fish to shine through rather than being overpowered by cheese. So while the desire to grate some Parmesan over a finished dish may be strong, we strongly urge you to respect the fish and enjoy it on its own terms.
"I will have the Cajun catfish."
"Anything else?"
"Yes, how about a verse of Killing Me Softly?" "You're gonna sneeze on my fish, aren't you?"
Fish can be delicious and healthy, but just how healthy often depends on where that fish comes from and the conditions in which it lived. In other words, seafood sustainability is the name of the game. Jessica Randawa, the head chef and writer behind The Forked Spoon, told Mashed, "Easily the most significant mistake people make when ordering seafood meals is not quickly researching the sustainability of the fish being ordered. Fortunately, checking the sustainability of the fish on the menu takes less than a minute, thanks to resources like the Monterey Bay Aquarium Seafood Watch. If you're trying to make healthy choices with seafood, it's worth taking those extra few steps to ensure that item actually is healthy, both for you and for the rest of the planet." If you're planning on ordering fish as your entree, keep that in mind when ordering your appetizer. Omar Torres, food and beverage director at Banzai at Hilton Pensacola Beach, told Mashed, "If you are having fish as your main entree, it's not a good idea to have an appetizer that's gamey, such as lamb, bison, or pheasant, because it will change your palate in a way that you won't be able to enjoy the delicacy of a soft, flaky fish. When it comes to the fish itself, it's probably best to avoid cream sauce." According to Rowena Murakami, co-founder and master chef of Tiny Kitchen Divas blog, "Cream sauce does not do the fish any favors, masking both its texture and flavor. Instead, consider how each of your courses and sides will taste together. The idea is to pair the fish with ingredients that complement it." According to Murakami, "Go for what goes well with its natural sweetness. Ginger and citrus-based sauces are my recommendations, for these do not overpower the fish." From sashimi to deep frying, there is a universe of delicious seafood preparation styles out there.
"I'm sorry, ma'am, but everything on the menu has fish in it."
"What about the bread? Does that have much fish in it?"
"Yes."
Dining at a restaurant is the perfect opportunity to branch out and try a new type of fish or preparation that you haven't tried before. That's why it's a mistake to always go for the same thing, even if it's your favorite. If you're unsure what to order, take a tip from registered dietitian and seafood blogger Rima Kleiner, who told Mashed, "If you always order shrimp or salmon, ask what the local catch is that day and try a new species." Even if you don't find a new favorite, it's always fun to explore new flavors and branch out a bit. Or if you're reluctant to step totally out of your comfort zone, go for a mixed assortment. Experimenting with new flavors will give you a better idea of what's out there and what to order next time. Fish preparation styles can be kind of confusing, especially if you are new to the world of seafood. Not sure what poached or pan-fried or blackened means? What the heck is the sous vide method anyway? If a menu uses a term you're not familiar with, simply ask the server or chef to explain how the seafood is cooked. Understanding the preparation method for each dish can really help inform your decision. According to Kleiner, if you're looking for a light option, stick with grilled, poached, seared, broiled, roasted, or blackened. For a heavier option, there is fried, battered, or buttered. Asking these questions will also give you an idea if it's an ingredient or a style you need to watch out for. For example, if you are monitoring your fat intake or overall daily calories, you might not want to get fried fish. But if everything else about the dish appeals to you, don't be afraid to politely ask if you can change up the preparation method. Kleiner advises, if a menu lists a seafood dish as deep-fried or battered, it never hurts to ask if the restaurant will broil or blacken instead. One of the mistakes people make when ordering fish is asking for a preparation that doesn't suit the fish. Although people may have their preference to only order fish grilled or fried, the truth is some fish are just better prepared a certain way. For example, according to Maketa Davis, co-owner of Lulu's Maryland-style chicken and seafood, lake trout is meant to be fried, as it will not hold the flavor well when grilled. The opposite could be said of salmon, Davis cautioned us, saying, "Salmon is better grilled and holds so much more flavor than when fried, even though fried salmon has become popular."
Salmon. Oh, I'm gonna say that again. Salmon. Who thought that was a good idea, right?
However, some varieties of seafood are a little more versatile. Lighter fish, such as tilapia or whiting, can be grilled or fried without jeopardizing the flavor and quality, said Davis. If you're stumped, consider asking about the restaurant's specialties and ask if your server can recommend a preparation based on your preferences. It's very possible you won't even know which preparation method will best suit your order until you ask. While it's not uncommon to skip over the appetizer menu and skip straight to the entree, you could be overlooking some tasty seafood options. Kleiner tells us, "A seafood appetizer makes a great way to start your meal, or even as the meal itself. As a bonus, many seafood appetizers tend to be prepared healthfully, simply, and in smaller portion sizes. That may be perfect for people with smaller appetites or those who may want to try something new without committing to it as their whole meal." Ordering fish as an appetizer also allows you to experience multiple varieties of fish in a single meal, making it the perfect solution for indecisive eaters. Anchovies have gotten an undeserved bad reputation as an unappealing ingredient, but don't be so quick to dismiss this humble little fish. Asking to hold or substitute the anchovies in any given dish is cutting out a whole lot of potential flavor that you don't even know you are missing. According to Haidar Karum, the chef and owner of restaurant Chloe, anchovies are pound for pound one of the greatest umami-rich ingredients used in cooking. Removing anchovies removes all of the magic they contribute to a dish. As a matter of fact, anchovies may be the secret ingredient that brings the flavor to some of your favorite dishes. Much-loved classics like Caesar salad, Vietnamese pho, and spicy pasta puttanesca all owe some of their characteristic flavor to the tiny fishes. So next time you're thinking about asking the chef to hold the anchovies, remember the advice of Karum, who urges us to consider getting past the notion that anchovies are offensively fishy or salty, and consider all the greatness they provide. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Mashed videos about tips for ordering food are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.